అస్మత్ గురుభ్యో నమః, అస్మత్ సర్వ గురుభ్యో నమః, అస్మత్ పరమ గురుభ్యో నమః. శ్రీమదే శ్రీ లక్ష్మీ నరసింహ పరబ్రహ్మణే నమః. శ్రీమదే శివంశతకో శ్రీ వేదాంత దేశికేంద్ర మహాదేశికాయ నమః. శ్రీమదే శ్రీ లక్ష్మీ నరసింహ దివ్య పాదుగా సేవక శివంశతకో శ్రీ నారాయణ ఏదీంద్ర మహాదేశికాయ నమః. శ్రీమదే శివంశతకో శ్రీ రంగనాథ ఏదీంద్ర మహాదేశికాయ నమః. శ్రీమాన్ వెంకటనాథార్య కవితార్కిక కేసరి వేదాంతాచార్య వరియో మే సన్నిధత్తాం సదా హృది జ్ఞానానందమయం దేవం నిర్మలస్ఫటికాకృతిం ఆధారం సర్వ విద్యానాం హయగ్రీవము వాస్మహే తమేవ మత్వా పరవాసుదేవం రంగే సయం రాజవదర్హణీయం ప్రాబోధయీం యోగృద సుక్తిమాలా భక్తాంగ్రిరేణుం భగవందమీడే மன்னுமதில் திருமண்டங்குடித்தான் வாழ மார்கழி மாதக் கேட்டை நாளில் வந்து துன்னு புகழ் தொண்டரடி பொடியே நீ முன் துழாய் மாலை பணி அடிமை செய்து நாளும் தென்னரங்க மணவாடற்கு அன்பு மெக்கு செப்பிய நல் திருமாலை நாற்பத்தைந்தும் பன்னிய நல் திருப்பள்ளி எழுச்சி பத்தும் பழவடியேனுக்கு செய்பறிந்து நீயே மன்னிய சீர் மாழ்கழியில் கேட்ட என்று மாநிலத்தீர் என்று இதனுக்கு ஏற்றம் என்னில் உரைக்கேன் துண்ணுபுகழ் மாமறையோன் தொண்டரடி பொடியாழ்வார் பிறப்பால் நான் மறையோர் கொண்டாடும் நாள். இந்த தனியன் பி சேட் தி ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஒன் இஸ் தி தனியன் ஃபார் திருப்பள்ளி எழுச்சி. And Arayar has done that one. The next one is Swami Desigan has said in the Prabandha Saram. And the last one is from Manavala Mamunigal, he said in the Upadesa Ratnamala. Adiyan was asked to do about the Kulasegara Azhvar and Tondaradippodi Azhvar. Suresh was asking that one. Kulasegara Azhvar, we did about 6 months back, and that is available on the record on the YouTube. So that's why I picked Tondaradippodi Azhvar today, and also Tondaradippodi Azhvar was born last month, Margari Masam. So that's why we will do that. But there is a connection. So that is the reason why Suresh might have asked. Kulasegara Azhvar said, Kushyade yasya nagare rangayatra dhine dhine. So he wanted to go to Srirangam every day. That is what he was planning. But all the people in his palace, they try to bring some adidhi, so that when the adidhi comes, he has to do the upacharam. So he would not go to Srirangam and stay in the same place. So every day in his mind, he wanted to go to Srirangam. On the other hand, Tondaradippodi Azhvar, that is the only place he stayed all along. So this Kulasegara Azhvar wanted to do, in his mind he wants to go, but Tondaradippodi Azhvar, both his mind and body, he stayed in Srirangam. So both of them had a good connection with the Srirangam. Azhvars, we know, there are 10 Azhvars. If you include Andal and Madhuragavi, there are 12. But we just take only 10 because Azhvargal Padinmar. All the Tamil says Padinmar means 10. 10 Azhvars are there. Madhuragavi and Andal is not included in the sense. When you say Namalvar, Madhuragavi recession is included. When you say Periyarvar, Andal the Sishya is included in there. So all the 10 Azhvars, they have sung about Srirangam. But there is only one Azhvar who sang only about Srirangam. That is Tondaradippodi Azhvar. The Bhuloga Vaiguntam, what we call, if you look at the Divirasam 1 through 108, number 1 is always listed in Srirangam. 108 is always the Sri Vaiguntam, Paramapadam, Moksham. That's what we call. So, when you look at this one, the Tondaradippodi Azhvar, he sang only Srirangam, nothing else. But there is a slight controversy on that one. Some people might say it is not actually, he sang three Divyadesam. It's again, everybody's creative way of interpretation. In the Tiruppalli Ezhuchi, one place he says, ஆட்டிய அடுதிரல் அயோத்தியம் அரசே. Yes, use the word Ayodhi. So whenever in many places there are some Divyadesam, there is only one Shabdam, not a huge description. For some of them, he has written about 120 Pasuram, Thirumangai Azhvar. For some Divyadesam, there is only one Shabdam. Even then it is called a Divyadesam. So whenever he used as a, this one, Ayodhiyam Arase, some people say this has been used for Ayodhi. And the same way, in the Thirumalai, he says, Ini Thirai Thivalai Mode Eriyum Than Parvai. Thivalai means all the tides. So when all the tides were flowing and the Bhagavan was lying down, and when he says like that way, they say it is Parkadal, Thirparkadal, not Srirangam. So when you look at all these kinds of things, some people interpret he has sung three Divyadesams, Srirangam, Thirparkadal and Ayodhi. But his general, our customs, our acharyas says, he has sung only one place, Srirangam. When you take the Azhvars, the chronology of the Azhvars, Swami Desikan gives in his Prabandhasaram. Vayyagaman poigai bhudam pe Azhvar, Maisergon magilmaran madurakavigal, Poyil pugal koliyargon vishajittan pungodai, Tondaradippodi paana Azhvar, Ayyanarul kaliyan edirashardam odu. He gives the whole list of them. In that one, in Prabandhasaram, because he has to include all the Azhvars who have sung for the collection of 4,000, so he has put all of them, including Ramanujan for Ramanujanutrandadi. So remove those three, Andal and Madhurgaviyar and Ramanujan, so we get 10 Azhvars. In the 10 Azhvars, this Tondaradippodi Azhvar has been put as the 8th one. After one, is Thirupan Azhvar 9th, Kaliyan Thirumangai Azhvar is the 10th. So he was put as the 8th one. 8th is a very amazing one in our Sampradaya, because the most important mantram, Thiruvashtaksharam, Thirumandram, what we call as the 8th one. So Thiruvashtaksharam has got 8 and this Azhvar has been put as the 8th one. In the Thiruvashtaksharam, the most important is what? The Pranavam. So this 8th Azhvar, he sang only about Pranavam. What do you mean by he sang only about Pranavam? If you look at Srirangam, the Puranam says, Kaveri viracha doyam vaigundam rangamandiram sa vasudeva rangesa pratyaksham paramam padam vimanam pranavagaram vedashringam mahadbudam Srirangasai bhagavan pranavarta prakashaha. Pranavartam, the vimanam what they have, what Perumal gave to Brahma and then it came through Rama and then it came to Vibhishana, that Pranavagara vimanam, Siranga vimanam is Pranavagara vimanam. What you see inside there, it is the Paravasudevan. That is, and the Kaveri is nothing more than Virajanadi. That's what it says. So, what he has done is the Pranavam, that a Perumal who is lying down inside there, is the Sakshat Pranavagaram, the meaning of the Pranavam. Attaksharatil Pirandi, that's what we say. We know our Surubam only through the Attaksharam. So that is why when you look at, there is a connection, the Azhvar 8th in chronology, he was singing about the Attaksharam, the most important part of that one is the Pranavam. That is what he is singing on that. Let's look a little bit about the history of this Azhvar and the Vaibhavam, the two Prabandhams he wrote, and what is the greatness about this Azhvar compared to the others. All the Azhvars are great. Today we say this Azhvar is great because we are talking about him. So it's a Nahin India Nyayam. He was born in a place called Thirumandangudi. Thirumandangudi is very close to Kumbakonam. If you know Pullambudungudi, Adanur Divyadesam, it is very close to that one. He was born in a place where, that is, a Brahmin family is there, and the Brahmin family has got the front Kudimi. Munkudimi Soriya, that's what they call. They have the, there are only 4 Azhvars, out of all the Azhvars, they are all Brahmins. Periyazhvar, Tondaradippodi Azhvar, Andal, Madhuragavi. These are the 4 that's in the born in the Brahmin family. He was born in Margadi Ketai, Jeshtha Nakshatram.
Azhvargal, if you look at it, Swami Desikan says, they are all Nityasuris. The Nityasuris has been sent down to earth so that you can go and spread the Bhagavan's word and change all these people into the spiritual feeling and ask them to do the Sharanagadi and go and hold the feet of only Lord Narayana only and nothing else. That is how you come to the Moksham. What Perumal could not achieve in his avadharam, he has asked the Azhvars to go and do as a human being to do all these things. So Bhagavan has got so many different things on him. One of them is a beautiful Vaijayanti Mala. The Vaijayanti Mala is the one we call as the Vanamala. And that is, it never fades, it never loses its luster, it never loses its color, it never loses its fragrance. That Vanamala Amsham was Tondaradippodi Azhvar. That is the reason why he came here and he was doing the Nandavana Kaingaryam later on. His birth name is given as the Vibhra Narayanan. Vibhra, Sanskrit words, if you look at that one, there are several meanings. So that is why you can twist and turn any which way you want it. If you look at the Vibhra means, common things, we take it as a Brahmin. It means holy, it means inspired, it means sage, priest, learned, all of them are equivalent to Vibhrana. So his name is Vibhra Narayanan. Why they give the Narayanan? This Azhvar, we don't have the four Divyadesham, Srirangam, Tirupadi, Kanjipuram, Melkote, Tirunarayanapuram. None of the Azhvar has sung about Tirunarayanapuram. But this Azhvar's parents, they went to Tirunarayanapuram. They prayed for that Perumal, wanted to have a baby. And when the baby was born, that is the reason why they put him as a Narayanan. So, the Narayanan from the Melkote, that is why they put as a Narayanan. So, he is called Vibhra Narayanan. That is his name. Later on, you will be taking the name as the Tondaradippodi Azhvar, you know. This Azhvar, when he was born, he was learning everything from his father. Becoming a Brahmin, he learnt all the Vedas and he went to the Padashala, Gurugulam and everything. He learnt all of them. And then he was so much interested only in Bhagavan, Lord Narayana. So, he wanted to visit the Divyadeshams. Let me go on this Thala Yatra in all the different places to have the darshan of the Perumal. So where should we start? He was in Kumbakonam. Probably is about 20 miles, 15 miles away from Kumbakonam. Next to that Pullambudungudi. That is the place. Thirumandangudi. That is very. So let's start with Srirangam. So he started to go to Srirangam. And let's go to the other Divyadesham after that. So when you go to the Srirangam, and he saw the Perumal lying down with all his beauty and everything, he could not take his eyes. He says, I don't need to go any other place. This is the place I will stay. He started with Srirangam. He didn't go to any other place. So this Tondaradippodi Azhvar, one of the greatness is, like our Acharyas, usually we say, Azhvars are mesmerized with Tirupadi Srinivasa Perumal. Because all the Azhvars did Sharanagari only to Tirupadi Perumal. All the Acharyas, they are all in Srirangam. They stayed in Srirangam. Maybe they have been brought up in Kanjipuram. Kanjipuram Tyaga Brahma. Kanjipuram Perumal, just like in the Upanyasam, they say, the father and mother, they bring the kid in India, so they give him food, put him into college, pay the fees and good college and everything. And once he gets married, he gives the money to his wife. Same thing, what happens is all these Acharyas, they've been brought up by Kanchipuram Perumal, and then all the knowledge they pour it into Srirangam Perumal. That is what they do. So he was mesmerized with the Ranganatha, and that is where he stayed. And he thought he wanted to do Kaingariyam for the Perumal. The best Kaingariyam, what he could really thought, is to do the Pushpa Kaingariyam. So Tiruthurai, Thurai, Thulavam, Thulasi, all of them are the same. Thurai Kaingariyam. So he wanted to do the Tiruthurai Kaingariyam. So he made a small Nandavanam garden, what is called as a flower garden, and he wanted to do the garlands for Perumal. The most important among that one is the Thulasi. Thulasi Mali. That is what he was doing. When we say three different things in the Anusandhanam, Nityanushtanam in the morning, Thirupallandu, Tiruppalli Elchi and Tiruppavai. These three we always say that one. And if you look at this, say Azhvars in the three of them, Tiruppallande Periya Azhvar, Tiruppalli Elchi, Tondaradippodi Azhvar, and then Tiruppavai is the Andad. These are the composers. And all the three somewhere are related to the flowers. When you look at that one. So that is why we start first Perumal with the Pushpam. So Periya Azhvar and Tondaradippodi Azhvar, they took the job of making a Nandavanam, cultivating the flower garden, and then making garlands and give it to them. Andal took a little different, she put it on herself and made that one Sreshtam. Without she putting that one, the flower garland will not have the holiness. So she did that one and gave it to Perumal. That is how Perumal got that Sri, including the garland. That's what he was getting. So all the three, when you look at that one in the morning, that is how we start with the three, Nityanushtanam, with the flower. In this two, Periya Azhvar and Tondaradippodi Azhvar cultivating that one. So that is the reason why both of them are called Malakarar. Malakarar means the one who is involved with the flowers and everything. So that's what it's called. And among them, Tondaradippodi Azhvar is with the Tulasi. That is the most important. The Tulasi, what they say, the for Deshigan's Avadaram, when you read that one, even at such a young age, even when he was a baby, he knew so much and you can see the Pragasam, Tejas on him. Just like a Tulasi. They always say, even a small piece of Tulasi, it will have the fragrance. Kurindi, that's what they call, the young budding one, that itself. So Swami Desigan is like that. So Tulasi is an amazing one. Unlike all other things, Tulasi, we can use it in any which way. If you have a leaf that is green and nice, that's okay. If you don't have something that is a little faded, still you can use. For Perumal, people may not use faded flowers. But Tulasi is not like that. If you have that one, green, that's okay. If you don't have that one, then it's a faded. Or if it is completely dry, the powder you can use. Even if it is not, there is a stem of that one you can use. And not only that, this Tulasi, you can put it on his feet. You can put it on his chest. You can put it on his Tirumudi. Everywhere this Tulasi can go. So when you look at this Tondaradippodi Azhvar, he found out that is the best I can do. So the Tulasi Kaingariyam, making the garland, Todayotta Tulavamam Kodayam Polinda, Todai Otta. So when you make this Tulasi garland, make sure it has to be in a correct order, beautiful, nicely connected. So you cannot start making the garland in the car. So Shanti makes that one like a Tondaradippodi Azhvar, makes all the garland and gave for the Perumal. Todayatta Tulavamam, Todai Otta means it is very nicely arranged, all the Artham. So this Tulasi Deshigan also brings in the Tattamutta Kalabam, Mangala Slavam also, he says the Tulasi is Tudukardi. When you put them into a garland, it has to be so close to each other. There is no gap. It looks like it's a dark Tulasi that has to be like a thick garland. That is how you have to make. So these are the things they try to show you how to make the garland. Todayatta Tulavamam Kudayam Polinda. So whenever you look at Tondaradippodi Azhvar, there are some Azhvars you can easily find out. Somebody was asking me, when you go to the temple, how we can identify Deshiga and Ramanuja. It is very, very simple. Correct. Grahastha and Sannyasi. Same way you can easily identify Nammalvar will always be sitting down. And Thirumangayavar will be there and also will be with his wife. Lot of places he can find with his wife and everything. Tondaradippodi Azhvar, he'll have the basket. And that basket is Tulavam. So the basket is to keep the Tulasi. That is Tulayatta Tulavam Kudayam Pulinda Tondaradippodi Ennum Adiyanai. What words you are using? We are going to compare some of the Azhvars and Tondaradippodi Azhvar. Amazing humility. Tondaradippodi Azhvar. But that comes not easy. So we'll talk about Tondaradippodi Azhvar. He might have lived during the same period as the Tirumangaya Azhvar. Because when he made this Nandavanam, Tirumangaya Azhvar was constructing, because Sapta Pragara Madhye, that's what we say for Srirangam, seventh Pragaram. The fourth level Pragaram, he was constructing the Madhul, the wall. When he was constructing the wall, the Tondaradippodi Azhvar Nandavanam is right in the middle. So what he did is, he made the path to move away from that. Not to do any damage to the Nandavanam, he did that one. So that is one of them, they say. Both of them would be very, very close to the same period, because some of the things, the Azhvars, and in between them is the Tirupan Azhvar. He was also nearly closer to Tondaradippodi, Tirupanan and Kaliyan. Varisya, all the three are coming. But none of them has referred to the others and saying, like Pei Azhvar and Tirumisi Azhvar kind of a thing. None of them has referred. But we can find out something. For example, Tondaradippodi Azhvar used one of the utensil, whatever that instrument, to do the kalayadagar, or the to dig the hole, to make the garden. The name for that one, he has given the specific title for Tirumangaya Azhvar. And I forgot the name of that one. So, the name for that one, Arulmari, something he has given for the Tirumangaya Azhvar's title. And then, not only that, if you look, two lines of Thirumalai is exactly lifted and put it in Thirukkurundandakam. So if you look at that one, let me see what is the two lines. Maybe I'll tell you at the end. So the two lines, when you look at that one, Karam Bamar Solai Sunda Arangama Koyil Konda கரும்பினை கண்டு கொண்டு என் கண்ணினை கழிக்குமாறே திருமாறை. Same lines in Thirukkurundandakam. So, the Tirumangaya Azhvar might be slightly younger than him to pay respect to this Azhvar. Just like Embirmanar, in his thing, uses a Stotratnam. Four stanzas he exactly lifted and he put it over there. Because he says, I cannot say any better. Whatever the Purvacharya had done, I use it exactly like that. So, Tirumangaya Azhvar might have used, you might have known about him, he is a god, he is a Thirumalai and everything, to pay respect he might have done. So these are all the historical events, they are trying to put a conjecture, because nobody has done on that one, written everything on those days. Tondaradippodi Azhvar is called so many different names, Bhaktangri Renu, Mandangudiya, Vibhranarayanar, Palli Unarthiya Piran, Pattaradippodi, Anbarthal Thuli, so many different words he has been called on that one. Deshiga calls these Azhvars are Abhinava Dashavadharam. Perumal's Dashavadharam is these Azhvars. So this Azhvar is compared to Balarama. In the historical way of comparison, is compared to the Balarama. He has sung about two different things. One is Thirupalli Ezhuchi, which is 10 stanzas. The other one is Thirumalai, 45 verses are there. So we'll look at some of those things at the end after we look at the history of the Azhvars. Tirupalli Ezhuchi is the only Azhvar who sang Suprabhadam to Perumal. Okay. And even now, all the temples, he sang only for Ranganatha. Everybody uses that. Even though Kausalya Supraja Rama, we say for Vengadesha Suprabhadam, which came later. The Kausalya Supraja Rama, the first two lines is lifted from Ramayana. The rest of them are written by Annan. Okay, Pradyavadi Bhayangaram, Annangaracharya, the first one. First Annan in that family, he wrote that one. What happened is, at that time, just to give a historical event, when Manavada Mamunigal, he is a session of Manavada Mamunigal. He also wrote the great about the Deshiya. Okay, he said Saptaratnamalika and all other things also, he wrote about that. When Manavada Mamunigal was visiting Trivengadam and he was asking, is everything is going on, how is the puja and everything. So all the people said everything is great here, but we don't have anything to say about Perumal in the morning. We don't have anything. So Pradyadi Bhayangaram, Annan was standing next to him as a disabled. Annan, come on, sing. He said that, it poured down from him. That is how you wrote this Suprabhadam. So that is what everybody says, that one. But still, Azhvar's Suprabhadam, when you say that one, that is the first one. This is the one he is sang about Ranganada, and that is what used in all other places. Amazing thing, he asked about two Azhvars. One is Kulasekhar Azhvar, the other one is Tondaradippodi Azhvar. We are singing looking at Tondaradippodi Azhvar, who wrote the Palli, Thiru Palli Elichi. Palli means lying down, Elichi means get up. So he was waking up the Perumal. Who puts the Perumal down to sleep? Kulasekhar Azhvar. Kulasekhar Azhvar, Tharelo, he says, he is so mesmerized with Rama, but the Rama what he saw in Ranganada. So the Ranganada is no different than Rama. That is what he saw there. But the other Azhvars, like Tirumangai Azhvar and Tiruppan Azhvar, they saw him as a Krishna, Kannan. But he sang as like a Rama. So we started with the Tondaradippodi Azhvar, who opened up and wake up the Perumal, open the door and everything, wake up the Perumal. And then the Kulasekhar Azhvar, the other one, yes. That is why Suresh was so nicely asked these two Azhvars. So Tondaradippodi Azhvar, who started the singing about the Tirupalli Elichi. Yeah, the Aidigam is correct. The Utsava Murti is Rama and Moolava Murti we they call. But so now we will look at a little bit about the history of this Azhvar, and then we go into some of the Anubhavam on his songs and everything. This Tondaradippodi Azhvar is a unique one. The humility comes from him because we did the wrong things. We cannot say with our mouth like that one, because all of them are Bhagavan's Sangalpa. Okay? So one of the things what I am teaching right now on the Uttava Gita, two things we have to do. With the Krishna Charama slogan, we did the Sharanagati. With the Uttava Gita, we tried to calibrate ourselves to be a good Prabhanna. One of the major quality what you need to be a Prabhanna is don't judge others. How it comes that one is that's what we are going to look at that. So today I sent it to some people one of the puzzle kind of a thing. That is a classic example of Samadra Vicharaswagham. That is what Uttava Gita says, Perumal says, Samadrik. Have a samadrishti. Vicharaswa gham. Gham means bhoomi. Go around the world. So go around the world, but look everything is the same. So look everything is the same. Now we cannot look idli and alva as the same. But what it means, but both of them are going to be make your hunger to go down. Both of them are edible food. So when you look at the people, don't look at their external things, but inside all the atmas are the same. That is how you have to look. So when you look at here, this Azhvar, because he had a Nandavanam, not only others have to go like that, the Azhvar's life path is also was a little bit of a loop. So he was living in a Srirangam, having a nice Nandavanam, doing the Kaingaryam there. There are two girls who were, they call as a Dasi. Dasi means they try to be like a call girl, what do you call it right now. So they were doing entertaining in the king's court and everything. So in those days, Urayur is the Chola Empire's capital in those days. So these two girls, one girl is called Devi, the other one is called Deva Devi. So these two girls were dancing in the king's court. And when they come through Srirangam. And they come through this Nandavanam. They looked at that flowers. What a beautiful flowers, what a fragrance. Even Indralogam, Parijadam will not be like this. Such a beautiful one. So they were mesmerized by looking at them. Who is having all these things? Let's go and look at them. So when they went, and inside there is a small Parnasalai. Parnasalai means a small hut. So that is where this Tondaradippodi Azhvar is there. And when you look at him, Tondaradippodi Azhvar, he lived like a Brahmin. He lived like a Brahmachari life. Because he wanted to do Kaingaryam to Bhagavan and nothing to interrupt him. So he is having the Pandan Thiruman and everything, white punal, and a very nice Tulasi Malai, and what do you call, lotus bead, Mare, all the garlands and everything, and he is sitting and praying like that to Perumal. When these two girls were standing there, and this Vibra Narayana, that is his name, so he went outside, plucked the flowers, plucked this tulasi, come inside. He never noticed anybody standing there. So that is how he was doing all of them. So this Devadevi and Devi, Devi is the elder, Devadevi is the younger one. So the younger one was asking the elder, what is this guy? He's a nut, some crazy fellow. We are standing here, we are such a beautiful girls. He doesn't even have a glance at us. Either he's a blind or he's nuts in his head. So the elder sister told, no, he is not a nut. He is so much mesmerized in Bhagavan. He is doing Kaingaryam. And when he is doing Kaingaryam, he doesn't look at anything else. He goes and does that one. So the younger one got a little ego. And she said, how come he is not looking at me? I am going to make this guy to look at me and make sure that he falls on my feet. So that is a human ego. So that is what she said. The other girl said, no, you cannot. So they had some kind of a challenge. They put a bet on that. So the younger said, okay, you go back home. I will make this guy to fall on my feet. So she removed all her very expensive clothes and everything. She tried to put a very simple, very humble costume and everything. These are just an act. So to bring the other guy down. So she put all of them. She put a saffron kind of a thing to show that she is renounced everything. And she goes and stands next to him. Even then the Azhvar doesn't look at her. One day, 2 days, 3 days, it goes for several days, the Azhvar never looks. Then one day she falls on the feet of the Azhvar. See, the one thing with the Sharanagadi, even if you do the Sharanagadi, not with the total intention, even to test the other guy, even for Galata, as a joke, still Bhagavan takes care of that. That is an amazing with Sharanagadi. So Azhvar is of that type. So when she did the Sharanagadi on her feet, then he asked her to get up, what is the problem, what you are doing? She says, my name is Devadevi, because of some curse, the previous Janma Pavam, since I've been born as a Dasi, I'm doing dancing in the king's court. I changed my mind and everything. So I wanted to do the Kaingaryam here. So you are doing the Nandavanam. So I would help you try to put the water, pluck the flowers and help you in all of them. So when somebody says I will do the Kaingaryam, it is very hard to refuse. You have to understand in Azhvar's thing. Even if it can lead you into the wrong thing, when somebody asks, can I go and put the garland together? Can I do this tulasi? Don't refuse anybody. Mm-hmm. See, we are learning all these things from the Azhvar's thing. So he says, okay, you can do some of them. I will do the others, you do that. So they will be doing like this. But Bhagavan wanted to play something. So one day there was a very heavy rain. And the heavy rain, she was doing some work and she was wet. When she was wet, the Azhvar was inside this Parnasalai. He asked, why don't you please come in? You don't have to stand in there. So because she is wet, he gave his uttariyam to her. So when he gave the uttariyam to her, and then no human being is away from kama. See, the one thing with the Uddhava Gita, what I am telling, you can go and listen to that one. We take it from Brahma Sutram, the Vriddhi, what is Bodhayanar has written. The Bodhayanar Vriddhi, he says to get the bhakti and several things he is listing, six of them. Vimogam and Vivekam. He starts with Vivekam, first, second is Vimogam. Vimogam means mogam, you know, is some kind of an inclination. Infatuation. And that mogam becomes intensified, it can become a kama. Kama, krodha, moga, lobha, madha, matsaryam. Shadvargam, that's what we call. So the way you can interpret either kamam as a friend or the mogam as a friend, but I take it as the mogam because you had to have some inclination on something first. And when you have that inclination, madhi mayakam, that is in Tamil, that is called mogam. Your mind is not clear at that point. Not necessarily you are fully into that. When that intensifies, goes into your lust, then it is a kamam. Kamam is good. Kannanike amadu kamam, Ramanujan Uttrandadi. Desika says, in Ragasetra Saram, in all other things, we need asai, we need desires. But that desires has to have a U-turn away from the worldly things and go into Perumal. Ukkur Azhagi singer beautifully says in the Sharanagadi, if you don't have no desires, there is no moksha for you. We had to have the desire, but the desire has to be in a proper place. In the case here, this Vibhranarayanan, because of the Bhagavan's Leela, he falls in love with her. And then he lives with her for some days in the Parnasalai. And this girl, she won the bet. So she is slowly getting everything from him. What is this? He's a poor Brahmin. He is doing the garland work for Perumal. How much money he will have? He may not have that much. So finally he gave all of them. When everything is gone, he became a pauper and he became a bankrupt. She has left. When she has left and went back to her mother's place. There is always a mother-in-law in every story. So she went into her mother's place. And this Vibhranarayana, what he cannot stand. So far his love was this Perumal. And now he gave up on making the garlands, taking care of the Nandavanam. He left and his mind is always with that girl. So he went to her home. So he left all of them, he went to her home. There, the mother was there. And she said, no, this girl will not come to you. She has gone with her relatives and everything. If you want, you have to bring enough money. Varadakshane, the other way, in those days. So she said, you bring the money, then only we can do. This guy does not have anything, what he will do? So he put his hand, I cannot do anything. He felt so sad. And there was a mandapam there. He went there and he sat there. So that was the story at that point in the Tondaradippodi Azhvar. Sri Ranganachiyar in the temple, she is asking Ranganatha, he is doing a great kaingaryam for you. Beautiful Tulasi Malai and everything. Why you are playing with him like that? There are so many people, this is always the case. So many people who doesn't even come close to you. Show your power there. Why you are testing all these people? They are nice and doing good things for you. And why you are testing them? Ranganachar said. So, Bhagavan, we always need a Purushagaragam. So, when Thayar said like that one, Bhagavan thought, okay, I'll do something. Because he wants everything. So, there is a vattils. When you do the Tirvaradhanam, you will have the Agyam, Padyam, Achamaniyam, and all of them. And then Suddhodagam. For the clean water, there's a vattal. For Ranganatha, you don't have to ask. It is a golden vattal. Such a huge golden vattal. So he took that one. He disguised himself as a small Brahmin. And he went to Devadevi's house. He went to Devadevi's house and knocked on the door. So the mother opens the door. And he says, look, I am Vibhranarayanan's servant. My name is Azhage Manavadan. And he says, the Vibhranarayana asked, you are asked for some money or something, some emergency. So he asked me to give this one. Such a huge golden vattal. She saw her eyes were all glittering. Oh, that's great. So she took that one. Then she said, okay, you can ask that Vibhranarayana to come. So the Azhage Manavada went to that Vibhranarayana sitting on the mandavam and told, see, Devadevi is home. They are calling you. So he got so excited. So then he says, okay, let me run. So this Tondaradippodi Azhvar ran into that house. At that time, the mother didn't even show the Devadevi. And she said, she has gone with her relatives. But today onwards, you can come to this house. So this is what the story was happening. Next morning, the Bhattacharya and everybody opened the temple, the door. and they wanted to do the suprabhadam for Perumal, and they saw there is one big piece is missing. So they went to the king. The history says they don't even write down what is the king's name. History does not have even the king's name. So they went to the king and then they told, this is what happened. And in those days, kings are such a way, they don't even want to have a small flaw, any error in their empire. They will give up their life. They want to be such a noble kings. That is what they are. So when they felt, I did so much good in this, and I wanted to have a righteous kingdom over here, and something happened like this, I feel very sorry for that. So he has asked all the temple archakas to go and test them, to go and find out whether they got that one. So everybody was tested over there, tried to find in their home, searched in their home and everything, questioned and all of them. What a bad thing. You are such a noble man. You are doing kaingaryam in the temple and you will be put into this one. You give your life, you give your wealth, you give every breath for Ranganatha, and they call that you are a thief and they try to steal. How each archaka might be feeling. So the king felt that one in his heart, but he has to do the justification. But he couldn't find anything. And one of the person who was in the Devadevi's house, and they found out there was a golden bottle. So they said to say, I don't know, this old woman, she got a new golden bottle. So she said, no, I have a male servant came here. And male servant of Vibranarayanan. So everybody arrested Vibranarayanan. He said, servant, I am the servant. I don't have any servant for me. I am the lowest in the organization chart. I don't understand. I met one guy, Alage Manavalan, and he said, go there. That's why I went there. I don't have no idea Alage Manavalan gave, and I don't know that person. I never seen him in my life. But the king looked at that one, Vibranarayanan, so long he did such a nice job of doing this Thulavamale garland and everything. Why should he go and steal? When you are here to give it to the Perumal, the only thing you take from Perumal is the prasadam. That's it. Nothing else. So you would not have taken that one stolen. That's what he felt. He felt so sad the whole night. So Ranganacharya again told to the Perumal, I ask you to go and solve the problem. Now he created a bigger problem to the king and everything. The whole country is involved. Why did you do like this one? So Bhagavan does not know. Okay, let me go and resolve this problem. So he went into the Sopanam. He went to the king's dream. And he told, this Azhvar Vibranarayanan is a very honest person. And because of his purva karma, he has to go through a loop. That is what I send him on the other side. So he went on that one. He didn't steal that one. The Alage Manavalan is me. Nobody else. Sakshat me. So I went down there and I gave that one so that he can go and have some pleasures with that one. But I never thought it will turn out like this. And everybody was suspected in the temple. That is not correct. So he told the king the truth. This is what the truth. The morning when the king wake up and he felt very, very happy. Bhagavan saved me not to punish. See, this is one thing. Even a convicted is released, it's okay. If you're honest guy, should not be punished. That is the law, it says. If the convicted was, if he done the crime, if he goes away, if he does a second crime, he will get caught, definitely. But an honest person should not be done. So the king felt very, very happy that this never happened. The Bhagavan saved his life and everything. Bhagavan saved his empire and everything. So the Azhvar now he realized what problem he has caused. So this lust, the mogam, that is what the Azhvar's thing, what we learn. And Krishna very much tells to Uddhava. Uddhava is at the age of 124. But Uddhava is a vyajam. Like Krishna uses Arjuna as a vyajam. Astana snega karumi dharma dharma diya kulam Partham Prabhanna Uttrishya Sastra Vadharanam Kridam. Alavandar beautifully says, Partham Prabhannam Uttishya. Uttishya means Vyaji Kritya, Deshiyan Svyakhyanam. So Vyaji Kritya, he has used him as a Vyajam, and that is how he told the Bhagavad Gita. The same way in the Bhagavad Gita, last sloga we take and do Sharanagari, Uddhava Gita, the whole thing we take it and we calibrate, we polish our life to be a better Prabhannas. So when you look at this Tondaradippodi Azhvar, when he committed that mistake, when he realizes, he felt so bad, so low of himself. How I am going to do the kalvai, that is what in Tamil, in Sanskrit it is called prayaschittam. In English is the atonement. What is the atonement for this? Bhagavan will not forgive this, because there are several crimes are there. He is the only Azhvar who had done such a huge crime. Adultery. Thirumangai Azhvar also done, but he was just a small one, misdemeanor. Stealing is no problem. Relative to this one. Okay. So he felt so bad, even Bhagavan will not forgive this one. So he went, when you don't know what you do, you go and ask the elders. So he went and asked the elders, what is the prayaschittam for this? He said, the only thing that is to do is go and do the Bhagavata Kainkaryam. The Bhagavata's Pada Thuli, Renu. You take the dust and then put it on your head. You always have to feel Sri Pada Deertam. That is why one of the things in the 5 yagyams we have to do, like a Deva Yagyam, Brahma Yagyam, Manusha Yagyam, when we say like that one, in that one for the Acharyas, we have to give respect. We have to give respect for the elders. We have to give respect for the Vedas. Without Vedas, we would have been completely blind. We don't know what it is. So, what is the respect you have to give for Acharya means, several of them, Desigan says, there is nothing we can repay. Pundil potrugopadum, pundil kolvadum, pongu povai shatri valarpadum, shattallavo munnam petradarke, he says. Think about it. There are some places here you can see in the Tridandi Jir and everything, they do the Pada Puja. In our Acharyas, we don't publicize all of them. They do the Pada Puja and we do the Sripada Deertam. Sripada Deertam, they won't give you easily. You have to go and insist that you need. Otherwise, you won't leave that place. Then only they give you. Usually, they don't give that one. So, Sripada Deertam. So, in this case, what they say, Bhagavata, when you say, who is the Uttama Bhagavata? Acharya is Uttama Bhagavata. The all list, Bhagavata is the Acharya is the first one. So, they said, go and take the Sripada Deertam of the Bhagavadas. That is the prayaschittam for you. So, that is the reason why this Vibhra Narayana has been changed into Tondaradippodi Azhvar. Tondar means Adiyar, devotees. Adi means their feet. Podi means this dust. So, he takes the dust and put it on that. The dust of the feet of the Adiyars, that can cure more what the Bhagavan can pardon, what the Bhagavan can forgive. That is the one of the most interesting thing in our sampradayam. And we see that one, Bhagavat Seshatvam. Bhagavat Seshatvam nudi extreme LI is the Bhagavata Seshatvam. We saw all of them in the Rasaprasaram. So that is what he finally did. He didn't go to Ranganatha and ask for the mercy. But he asked for all these Bhagavata Uttamas to forgive him. So that is why he is called as the Tondaradippodi Azhvar. There is a beautiful story in the Guru Parambara they have written. In the Guru Parambara, the Kuratalvan's son is Bhattar, Parashara Bhattar. Parashara Bhattar is an amazing, very young person. He lived only up to 32 years. And he is such a knowledge, Parashara Bhattar. He is called as the adopted son of Ranganathan and Ranganachyar. So he can just walk in any time to Perumal. Because he's like a baby. Baby never looks. He, whatever the bedroom or living room, it goes in straight. So he always goes in. So, but such a knowledgeable one. He wrote beautiful Rangarajastavam, Sri Gunaratna Kosam and everything. So, butter, his session is Nanjiyar. Nanjiyar is the one he won in Melkote. He went there. Nanjiyar was a smarta. And then he won on the argument with the Tirunadan Dandagam. And then he came and surrendered. And that is why he was converted. It's called Namjiyaro. Nanjiyar. So, he became a Nanjiyar. So, Nanjiyar was sitting under his feet and he was trying to explain. So, Nanjiyar was asking the question, how come this Tondaradippodi Azhvar, such a great person, why he was asked to do like that? Why he was put to do an action like this? That he was asking. So, Bhattara was laughing. Oh, this is very easy. It's been told in so many places. In Treta Yugam, Rama, the beauty of Rama, however you can argue on that, the beauty of Rama is million times more than Krishna. Krishna's beauty is mesmerized by Gopikas and everything. Rama's beauty, every male was mesmerized like that. They wanted to be like a female with him. So Rama is such a beautiful one. So these rishis, they all felt, Rama, we wanted to, because Rama is such a beautiful one. Then Rama told, I cannot do anything. I am a Ekapatni Vradan. Even Shurpanaga. If you look at the Ramayana, the bad people, they use an amazing words to describe about Perumal. All of Mandodari, when you look at them, Mandodari is a nice person except she was Ramana's. And Shurpanaga, all the words they use, they use the words like Parabrahma. So that means you should understand when they know that, that means because of the karma, there is nobody is bad. When you look at the Atma, everybody's Atma is the same way. Only when that is attached to the attribute is Dharma Buddha Jnanam. Then only we do the wrong things. So the Dharma Buddha Jnanam is distributed to you based on your Prarabdha Karma. That is what is making. So, we should look beyond that one. The Atma is a sacred one. Bhagavan loves all of them. Everything is a sariram for Bhagavan. That is how we have to look for. So, in this case, Shurpanaga was asking Rama. Even though Rama, what he did not give the anubhavam for all the rishis. Rama said, okay, in the next janma, I am going to become a Krishna, and you will all be born as a Gopika, and you will all be born as the princess. All of these people, you can enjoy me. That is what he was said. So the Shurpanaga was asking. Rishis were very good. So in the next janma itself he gave. Shurpanaga was bad, so it takes a little while. So for Shurpanaga, he said, okay, you will become a Kundi. Next one out of this one, you will be, Kuni. I misspoke. Kuni. You will become a Kuni. So you will become a Kuni in the next janma. The Kuni is the one who does the Sandana. She is grinding the Sandana stone, and that one takes the Sandana and he gives to the Kamsa. And she was doing like that one. So she is a hunchback. So that is what she was doing. There is a Kuni, yeah. Oh, you do? Ramavadarla or Kuni. This Kuni is in the Krishna Avadaram. Her job is to make the Sandanam, give it to Kamsa. At the Kamsa Vadam, Krishna coming. At that time, something has happened. Same thing with the Malakara also. He usually sells the flowers and everything, double the price. On that day, something has happened, he gave it to Krishna. Same thing, this Kuni gave the Sandanam to Krishna. Krishna put it on his chest. So, Sandanam is one of the most intriguing thing. Bhagavan loves that. Like the Tulashi. So, she gave that one. Then at that time, he said, okay, now you are step by step, you are improving Shurpanaga. So, she says, I wanted to have you. Immediately, he make her into a young, beautiful girl. When she made a beautiful girl, she says, Krishna, I wanted to have you. Oh, not that fast. So, he says, next janma, the Vanamala, what I am wearing, the Vaijayanti Mala, will be born as a Tondaradippodi Azhvar. And you will be as a Deva Devi. And then you will have him. So instead of me, the one that is closest to me is this Vanamala. And that is what you will have. That's what Krishna has said. And that is why Tondaradippodi Azhvar and Deva Devi. And the reason why he has to do, he could have made as his wife easily. But he didn't make that one. Because to show the Bhagavata Seshatvam is far higher. And we can go wrong and evaluating the people. Uttama Bhagavadas we will be evaluating. If he is a Prabhanan, he is a Prabhanan. He has got the boarding pass. He may be sitting and sipping the coffee. Who is he doing? You should not think like that. But he has got the boarding pass, he can get into the plane. That is what we want to know. So Prabhanas never evaluate. Even ordinary people, we should not do that. Especially Prabhanas don't do that one because they already have the boarding pass, they are going to go. So that is the one you wanted to show. So Butter was explaining the story, 9 year, this is the way. That is the reason why Bhagavan played all this trick and everything. This, Tondaradippodi Azhvar, in his Thirumalai, he uses that one. He shows the one of the highlights of the Tondaradippodi Azhvar's. Idhile Mayangum deer, which one? It will fall prey easily into music. Music. Remember that. So, I always say that one, music can be used only for Bhagavan. When you do, Bhagavan is number one. Music is an instrument to enjoy him. Not the other way. So, don't put too much. Each one does a lot of different things. For us to enjoy Perumal, music comes only second. Music is a tool. So, not as a music to show your greatness of that one, but music to show the how the Bhagavan can be enjoyed. Okay. So, in this one, Madadar Kayarkan Ennum Valayul Pattu. So, I fall prey into that net and I forgot myself. Podare Endru. Don't go there. That is called Podare. Podare Endru Solli Pundiyil Pugundu. He got into my mind. Tanpal Adharam. Amazing word. What he uses. Adharam means tremendous kind of affection based on feeling bad. He's a good person, but he has done. Oh, I feel very sorry for him. That kind of an affection coming. That is called Adharam. Amazing word in Tamil. They use that one. So, Adharam. Even though I made a mistake, Bhagavan got into my mind, turned me into something and then hugged me and says, that's okay. You made a mistake. I am very affectionate to you. Who is that one? Ranganatha. I won't sing anybody else. That is what Tondaradippodi Azhvar says in Thirumalai. So, the other one he was singing is the Tirupalliyai. I just wanted to point out this verse because Azhvar himself told about his life history and Bhagavan has corrected him. He is the only Azhvar who went away and then came back. None of the Azhvars were like that. So that is the reason why he always felt through all his life such a humble person. In the Tirupalli Elchi, what he was to give something back to Perumal. Perumal, you wake me up. I am going to wake you up. That is why he did the Suprabhadam for Perumal. Because Perumal wake him up. In the sense, he was so much mesmerized in the wrong things. So what he did, he patted on him and asked him to turn away, go into the right direction. Same way, I am waking you. What the Ubhagaram you have done, I am waking you up, turn you and do the good things for the people. That is why he did the Tirupalli Elchi. Thirumalai is another one what he has done. So we'll look a little bit here and there and then one of the days we'll go and have the anubhavam of all of them slowly. In the Thirumalai, best one you can see, everybody knows, Pachchaimamalai Bol Meni, Pavalavai Kamalai Chengan, Achuda, Amarere, Ayardam Kurinde Yennum. 6. Arusuvai Undi. That is the reason why he put 6 of them. Pachema Malebol Meni, Pavaravai, Kamalat Chengan, Achuda, Amarere, Ayardam Kurinde. There are 6 adjectives he uses for the Perumal. Arusuvai. Ahamannam, Ahamannam, Ahamannam. He is a Brahmin. He has seen all these Vedas and Upanishads. That is the reason why he exactly uses 6 in this place, adjectives. Pachema. Ichuvai Tavirayanpo Indira Logam Adum. Achuvai Perinum Vendain Arangama Nagarulani. Achuvai Perinum Vendain. He can do it in a different way also. Anda Suvai. Achuvai Ngade. What is Narasimhan? The name could be Narasimhan. They call him as Nachu. Achudan, Achu. Achudan means what? Achudan? Tottakai Puditta Perumal. Achudan means Achudan Kaimel in Kaivet. Andal says like that. Achudan. So you hold it tight and give you the Sorgologam also. I don't want it. That means hold it tight. Because we know Sorgologam and all the worldly pleasures, they have a stop clock. Okay? It starts. Time starts. Even somebody holds me tight and then they say, like Achudan, they hold me tight and tell me you can have it permanently. Still I don't want it. That is what it says. Achuvai Perinum Vendain Arangama Nagarulani. One of the beautiful Thirumalai, so many of them. Every single thing is beautiful. One of the beautiful I really like that is Vedanul Pirayam Nuru Manidadan Puguvarerum. Adiyum Urangi Pogum Nindai Padinai Andu Pedei Palagan Adu Agum Pini Pasi Muppudunbam Adalal Piravirendain. Beautiful. Beautiful. There is nothing equivalent to this one. I searched, maybe my search is very limited. I never found anything equivalent in Vedas or any other sastra. How he explains this one? Vedam says prayam nuru. Nuru prayam. 100 years for the human beings. Manidardam puguvarelum. If you go and have that jividam in that 100 years. Padiyum urangi pogum. Half that life is gone in sleep. Nindra e padinai anandu. The left is only 50 years. Out of that 50 years, Tondaradippodi Azhvar is amazing. If you look at that one, he says, Pedai Palagan. Pedai means baby. Palagan means toddler. Adu Agum. He doesn't even want to use the Yavanam. Next. Neer Numadendrivai. Ver Mudalai Maithu. Namalvar Sonar. Neer Numadu. Naan Yanadis. Just telling that naan, you'll get the ego. That is the reason he never used that. Same thing here. Tondaradippodi Azhvar doesn't want to say that one. Pedai palagan adu agum. That is what he uses the term. Pini, pashi, mupu, tunbam. Pini means disease. Pashi means hunger. Mupu means old age. Tunba means all the problems. When you deduct, I may have 3 minutes of happiness in life. The whole 100 years. That is what the Azhvar says. That's why, please, I don't want to have any life. So, the whole idea, what we are looking for, moksham. The word moksham means, is a release. What we want to have, a vidudalai, liberation. The liberation from samsaram. Because samsaram is both, like Swami Desikan says in the Tagasyatrasaram, it is the Visham Madhu. Visham is coated with the Madhu. So, like we always give something with the ten or the marandu, that's what we give for the babies. That's similar, the one Bhagavan is giving all of them. So, if you can remove the outside coating, you know samsaram is not that good. That is the reason. So, beautifully he explained that Pashram, let's say, out of this, what you got left? That's nothing. And that is what you are falling for. Urilen kaani illai, uravu mattoruvar illai. Karoli vannane, kadakannane, kadarigindre. Beautiful words. When you look at that one, Krishna, I am just kadarigindrein. What? How can you say that one in English?
Desperately
crying. So Krishna, that's what I am doing on that one. And not only that, Mal, Ereban, Isan, Kanandador, Kadake Gandum, Inganam Marandi Vargain, Erayen, Erayene. அடிக்கடி சொன்னாதான் ஞாபகம் வரும் மறந்து. ஸோ இதில் வந்து சொல்லச்ச, கங்கையில் புனிதமாய காவிரி நடுவு பாட்டு. காவிரி இஸ் ஹோலியர் தேன் கேஞ்சஸ். தட் இஸ் வை ரங்கநாதா டிட் நாட் கோ தேர். கிருஷ்ணா மைட் ஹவ் ஸ்டேட் நெக்ஸ்ட் டு யமுனா, பட் ரங்கநாதா கேம் ஆல் தி வே ஃப்ரம் நார்த் டு சவுத். ஸோ தட் இஸ் ஆழ்வார்ஸ் வேர்ட். கங்கையில் புனிதமாய காவிரி நடுவு பாடினா, வேறவர் ரங்கநாதா ஸ்டேஸ். ஓகே, ரங்கநாதா இஸ் தி ஒன்லி பெருமாள் தட் இஸ் டிசெண்டட் ஃப்ரம் மோக்ஷம். நோ அதர் பெருமாள் இஸ் லைக் தட். இஸ் தி ஒன்லி ஒன். ஆல் ஆஃப் தம் கேன் பி ஸ்வயம்பக்ஷ கஷேத்திரம். அதர் திங்ஸ் லைக் பத்ரிகாசிரமம், சாலக்ராமம், ஆல் தோஸ் கைண்ட் ஆஃப் திங், இன்க்ளூடிங் ஸ்ரீமுஷ்ணம். So all of them would be like that. Dodadri, we say that. But this is only one. So Azhvar sang, Kaveri is the move. Because that is where Ranganada is there. All the Divya Desams are also on the Kaveri banks, many of them.
Swami, that's a very interesting point, Swami, that you were mentioning. Azhvar has mentioned it this way. Swami, basically when the Paduka Sahasram, when comparing the Ganga and the Paduka, both of you originated from the feet of the Lord. And you have been purified on account of the touch of the Paduke. What is the added glory that you had due to the many walks that Rama and Krishna took in their avatarams on your back and rendered you more sacred? Several acharyas come and the cresting of those waves is really indicative of the proximity of Ganga to the Paduka. And therefore, your matchless is the salutation that Swami Desikan implies there. On the other hand, Veda Vyasa too, if we look at it in the Mahabharata, he declares that there are four things that are fundamental for moksham: Gayatri, Ganga, Gita and Govinda. So now, how do we say that, you know, Kaveri is not mentioned in the context of moksham, so how can Kaveri be superior to Ganga?
See, Kaveri is mainly superior to that one is only because of Ranganada and our Acharyas. So, Puranams can say a lot of things. Not necessarily all of them can be true. Some of them can be extended stories. The same way with the Idighasam also. Idighasam can say a little extension, like a Puranam, they may not have happened that story at all. Puranam. Idighasam is like your resume, just a little expansion. Little more like, instead of 100 employees managed, you say 120, something like that. But what we say, the reason why Azhvar have said Kaveri Punidamanade, main reason, all the Azhvars, Acharyas and everybody stayed there. So that could be based on Abhiman. Not necessarily, we don't want to fight any of them. Somebody says Ganga is great. Yes, he says Ganga is great. That's nothing wrong with that one. We are not trying to prove any of them. So this is this Azhvar's Anubhavam. Like he says Ranganada is the best. But somebody who is in a small temple, maybe it is not a Padasthalam, local temple, and he may have a faith on that. Dayton temple is higher than anything else. Because he likes that one. Nothing wrong, we enjoy all of them. So in this way, this one is Gangai, he says that one. There is one place in Thirunelundadagam, he says, Tamil is before Sanskrit. There is. I don't want to bring that one, but their explanations are different. He says Tamil is before Sanskrit. That's where it says. But we don't do that. What we do, how we say the Taniyans? We say the Sanskrit Taniyans, then only Tamil. It doesn't matter what chronology. Even the younger people wrote Sanskrit Taniyan, we say that one first. Not by the who wrote that. It's only Sanskrit first we take. So Gangai is in general, all the Puranas, all the Idikasa and everything, Ganga is great. go to the Ganga, you get moksha. That's what it says, you know. So that's nothing wrong. We are not degrading. Nahin India Nyayam. In this place, Azhvar loves that one. So Abhibana. So he says that. Naragame suvargamagum namangaludayanambi. If they tell one word, actually the word he is using is Govinda. Govinda is the word he is using. Moondru ezhuthu. Kathirabandhu. Yeah, so three letters. This is Govinda he is using. That name Govinda is the name you use that one. Even if the people here in Naragam, if they hear that one, immediately it will become Swarga. Mm. That is the Namam, Nama Mahime. Govinda Namam he is using not directly. Andal uses directly. He doesn't use them over here. Not Nachiketas. Yaman. Nachiketas is a little different. Nachiketas is a Kadobanishad where he goes to the Yaman and Yaman asks him to wait. That is why he is asking three questions. That's where the Kadobanishad comes. In general, then Vishnu Puranam, there is a slogan, and also in the Azhvars, there is a slogan on that one. It says that wherever the people Madhusudanan, they say that one, that Bhagavata, Yaman does not have the jurisdiction there. They cannot go. That is what Swami Vichaya Pasahastam Padadikame Yama Karnamule, that's a Vishnu Puranam slogan says. Where he says, Azhvar, in that place in a Vishnu Puranam, he says, you don't go there when there are Madhusudan and Bhagavadas are there. Here, when Madhusudan and Bhagavadas are there, go and do prostration to them, go and do namaskaram to them and come. That is what he says. Yamadhudas will not do anything. Naragame swargamagum. The last one he says, especially for us, Sombarai ugatti bodum. Sombarai ugatti bodum. Kadaiktarayan kadaike vivarum. Sombarai ugatti bodum. Bhagavan loves somberi, lazy people. What is the lazy people? What is the lazy people here? Correct. Correct. We didn't go for any other Ubhayam. We did the Pravati. And after that, all we had to do, Nisham Shayaha, Sugamashwa. Don't even do that. That is what he means, Sombari Uvattipolam. Beautiful pasuram. And I think we did that one in Ragasthata. One day we will take that one alone. That is called both Dwayam and Charmasloka. Explained in a single pasuram. So beautifully Azhvar has written on that. So finally, I just want to say a couple of things and conclude. This Azhvar is a very humble person because of this. You see that other Azhvars has got so many of them. Thirumalal Arulapatta Shadagoban. I've been blessed by Lord Narayana, Sriman Narayana. That's what he says. And then, Veda Payan Golda Valla Vishnu Jittan. The essence of the Vedam, I'm telling you, Vishnu Jittan. Priyadvar says. Even Asian says that one, Sandamigi Tamil Mariyon, Tupul Dondrum. They put the title in all of them. But this Azhvar, what he puts, Tulavat Tondaya Tulsi Tondaradippodi, Ilaya Punkavide Yelum, Yembirarki Iriyavare. All I do is the Kaingariyam, Tulasi Kaingariyam for the Perumal, and I am singing two songs for him, and that one, Ilaya Punkavide Yelum. Punkavire, it is almost like a sword. That is one. It may have errors, it may have flaws, it may not have rhymes. All these kinds of things. Still, Embiranakki Iriyavare. Satamurele Solala, Desi Nude Pasuram. Now, the guy? Satamurele Desi and Pasuram. வானுழந்தவர்க்கும் வருந்தவரும் எந்நிலைகள் தானுடனாய்வுக்கும் தரம் எங்கு நமக்குளரே கூணுள நெஞ்சுகளாய் குற்றம் என்று கண்டிடினும் தேனுள பாத மலர் திருவாருக்கு தித்திக்குமே கூணுள நெஞ்சுகளால் குற்றம் என்று கண்டிடினும் ஆல் அதர் பீப்புள் மே சே இஸ் மேபி கூணுளக நெஞ்சுகளால் ஈ செட் லைக் தட் பீப்புள் மே நாட் ஹாவ் எ குட் மைண்ட் குருக்கட் மைண்ட் They may say my song is wrong, but Thirumalakku Thithikkume, we say that one. Anna, this Azhvar, even he didn't say about anybody else. Anybody who calls this is even bad, even the learned people say, doesn't matter. Bhagavan, you like it. That's all I want. Such a humility with this Tondaradippodi Azhvar, which he cannot see in any other thing. So we'll conclude with today with this one. And Tirumalai is one of the beautiful ones. We can take it here and there and enjoy the inner meanings of the poem. Kavidharkiya Simhaya Kalyana Gunasalini Simare Venkateshaya Vedanta Gurave Namaha Simare Nigamanta Mahadeshidaya Namaha.